In the previous class, dear learners, in BEDA 002 week 9 part 1, we have talked about the process of value development and socialization, wherein we talked about how values are inculcated in the imprint period, that is when a child is born to around the age of 7. Then we talked about the modeling period, wherein a child follows whatever their idol is doing. Their idol could be the teacher, a sports person, a film star, or the parents, whatever the actions they see, or whatever the parents are speaking, they would inculcate this value. So this is the modeling period, which is between the age of 7 to the age of around 13. And then we have what is called the socialization period, which is the modeling period was from age around age 7 to around age 13 or around 12, wherein we talked about the modeling period. Then we talked about the socialization period, wherein we talked about how the peer groups were very, very, very influential. That is starting from the teenage years to maybe around 21 years of age, when the peer group influence was very, very important or was very significant. So we have talked about these three periods, the imprint period, the modeling period, and the socialization period. Now we will be talking about the role of home. We will be talking about the role of neighborhoods and the role of peers. So these are the very important group, or these are the very important people who influence or who inculcate values in children, and they make them become a accepted part of the society, a good member of the society. Now let us take the case of home. Let us now discuss home. Home is the first learning place. We have heard it I have said about home being the first learning place so many times, and you may have also heard it so many times, but it is very important to discuss home, because home consists of your immediate family. When a child is born, the first immediate people he or she has around is the family. The family is the basic social unit of the society, and whatever we learn from our family becomes our value system, forms or perceptions, and basis of actions. Since an individual is known by his or her actions, therefore, the most important role of family is to give proper identity. The family home environment influences the individual's learning throughout life, and the kind of experiences, pleasant and unpleasant, shape a child's personality. A sense of security is a basic prerequisite to all development, including learning. Children desire a conducive environment at home. When we talk about happy children, when we talk about well-behaved children, what is important is when we see or when we come across children who are well-behaved, who are happy children, in most cases it is seen that these are children who come from a conducive environment at home. They come from a peaceful environment at home, where the parents are teaches them values, inculcate values in them. They teach the children how to respect elders, how to respect others. The relationship between the parents are very good. They respect each other. So most of the children who are happy and who are well behaved comes from a family wherein the parents have taught them good values, wherein the parents respect each other, wherein the husband and the wife have a good relationship. During early years, the social and emotional environment of home becomes a critical factor in influencing the individual's learning and development. some of the basic strategies and styles of learning, in fact, begin to be molded even before the child goes to a formal school. That is why we are saying that school is the first home is the first school of learning before the formal school, because in the home or at home, the child learns all the informal learning that the parents have to teach the child or the children. The informal learning endeavors that children engage at home and in the surrounding community set the tone for their learning explorations in later life. So it is very important to know that the home, that is the first school of learning, set the tone for the child or for the children in their learning explorations in later life. If they come from a good, happy family, if they come from an environment, a neighborhood which is conducive, which is peaceful, which is harmonious, which is respectful to each other, the child grows up to become a well-behaved member of the society. So this is very important basic unit of learning, that is the home, wherein we say the home is the first school of learning for the child. How do you learn social, emotional and cognitive behaviors? Children learn many of the socio, emotional and cognitive behaviors through observing and imitating people who are significant to them, such as parents. Children often imbibe their fears, bias and values from their parents. Therefore, it is important that parents set an example to their children through their behavior rather than by preaching to them about what to do and what not to do. So the parents, if they do good actions in terms of, rather than that just teaching the children what to do, if they perform, if they practice what they preach, for example, if the parents teach their children or the child how to respect the elder, or they say they tell the children to respect the elderly, they themselves should respect the elderly at home or in the neighborhood. By seeing this action, the children would follow the parents' action, that is respecting the elderly in the family, in the neighborhood. Or if the children see that the parents, especially the mother, is respectful to the maid, if they have a maid at home, if the child or the children sees the parents behaving well with the maid or behaving well with visitors who come, then in future they would imbibe this caring attitudes in performing the same action, that is having a caring attitude to others. Maybe in future, if they are employing maid, then they will be respectful to the maid. So how the parents teach their children is by showing them through action, that is they practice what you preach. Instead of just talking and telling them what to do, they should also do the same action so that the children see the action of the parents and they follow them. Value system arise within our socialization structures. Symbolic values are transmitted in a cultural process by agencies of socialization like the family, the peers and the media. Parents are the main agency of socialization because it is the parents who help the children or the child to socialize, tell them how to speak, telling them the good manners, to become members of the society. And so parents are the main agency of socialization, and the school is also another agent of socialization. The media is also another agent of socialization. How do social and emotional experiences influence members of the society? This is what we are going to do next. any kind of learning process is influenced by the social and emotional experiences and characteristics of the environment. The nature and quality of emotional experiences, the sense of security and belongingness at home and in the immediate surrounding affect the value system of an individual. If children grow as secure individuals, they learn to trust people around them. So when we talk about children, the attachments children form with parents and siblings last a lifetime. They serve as models for emotional relationships and learning explorations in the neighborhood and society. At home, they understand the importance of physical surroundings and acquire the necessary coping skills and social norms of personal and group behavior. When we see children growing up to be children who are adults who are emotionally stable, in most cases we see that these are children, or this is a child who have a strong bond with the parents or the siblings. Because of this bond, because of this emotional strong bond, the child or the children grow up to be adults who have emotional stable relationship. Though so, the environment at home is very important in inculcating a emotional stable individual. They learn how to respect family, community, and other social groups. They learn how to adjust to others and live together, how to listen, how to give and take, how to forgive, how to appreciate others, and how to think for themselves. Within the family, individuals also acquire the notions about the importance of discipline and learn important lessons in compliance and cooperation that provide opportunities to take the perspectives of others into account. So the family teaches the children so many values. That is how to respect family, community, social groups, how to live together, how to adjust together, how to appreciate others. And one of the very important role of the family is also to inculcate the importance of discipline, and also inculcate the lesson in compliance and cooperation, because it is the family which the child sees, especially most of the time in the first few years of his or her life, because the child is living with the family. And it is through this family that the child learns discipline and also compliance, that is obedience and cooperation. So the quality of the home environment is very, very important, because during this period, the home environment is very influential and lasting, more lasting than any other phase of life. If a child sees the parents having a very good relationship, the child grow up to be a person who would be respectful to his wife, who would be helping out his wife in other spheres of life. But if the child sees the parents fighting during his childhood, then the child would later, I'm not saying in he would be or she would be, then the child in most cases would treat the his or her spouse badly. So the quality of the home environment, how the parents behave with each other, how the parents behave with the neighbors, how the parents behave with the elderly is very important in forming the values in the later part of a child's life. Gradually, the individual learns to be independent and begin to explore the world of objects and people outside home. Individual differences begin to emerge. They start having their own points about right and wrong and learn to differentiate between good and evil, good and bad. So the basic grounding of the values such as tolerance, respecting others, cooperation, obedience, discipline are all this depends on the quality of the home environment or family. If you see the parents of a child who are giving, then the child in most cases would be a giving person. If they see the parents respectful towards the others, the child would also grow up to become respectful towards others. The inculcation of value is a difficult task as it involves developing sensitivity to values, ability to choose right values and internalize them. If you analyze the source of values inculcation, then you would find that it lies in interactive behavior, either between parent or the significant others, that is the spouse, the respective spouse, or interaction with an individual or between peer and individuals. So this was what we just discussed, how the environment at home, the quality of the home environment is so important to inculcate good values in children, how the parents behave with each other, with others, with the elderly, how cooperation, values of cooperation, appreciation, compliance, that is obedience, discipline is formed in the first few years of a child's life, and this is what remains in the later part of his life. So that is how important home is as the first school of learning. Now we are going to talk about how peers develop value development. Who are peers? Peers are a group of people who have similar interests, age, background or social status, and they serve as an important source of information, feedback and support to individuals as they develop a sense of self. Peers help socialize an individual by reinforcing or punishing behaviors or interpersonal interaction. Peers are essential throughout one's social development, but research suggests this is particularly through during adolescence. That is, the influence of the peer group is very important during what is called the modeling period and the socialization period, because this is the time when you start having a group of friends whom you would identify as same with you, because they have the same behavior, they have the same attitude to life, they have the same taste and so on and so forth. Peer relationship provide a unique context in which children learn a range of critical social emotional skills such as empathy, cooperation and problem solving strategies. Peer relationship can also contribute negatively to social emotional development through bullying, exclusion and deviant peer processes. So it is very important to select your peer group who have a good influence on you, would help you to become a better member of the society. But however, if you fall into a bad peer group, then you would in most cases reflect what is called deviant behavior. As you become more independent, as you become more and more self-independent, the control of your parents over you starts diminishing. Your peers naturally will play a greater role in your life. People are influenced by their peers because they want to fit in, be like peers they admire, do what others are doing or have what others have. Peer pressure is very, when we talk about peer pressure can have a lot of negative impact on an individual, because it can lead to a loss of individuality. Extreme peer pressure may lead you to follow what your peers feel right. Their pressure may force you to go by everything they think right. Peer pressure can actually lead you to lose your taste in life and force yourself to begin liking what they like. So peer pressure can be very negative if it is extreme peer pressure, because peer pressure would pressurize you, would force you to do what your other members of the peer groups are doing. So it is very important that you realize that in most cases, extreme peer pressure is not good. You should have your own individuality. You should have your own identity. And in this regard, the role of the parents is very important. The role of the teacher is also very important, because the parents and the teacher should see that there is no extreme peer pressure, and that the child or the children grow up to have their own individuality and have their own identity. After talking about peer and value development, let us talk about how neighborhoods are important in terms of value development. How important are neighbors in terms of the values? How important is the surrounding in terms of how values are developed? What is a neighborhood? The people living near each other is called neighborhood. Common choices and shared values in neighborhoods lead to a concentration of positive and or negative characteristics. This in turn strongly affect the aspirations, attitudes and motivation of those who come from these neighborhoods. The adults in the neighborhood are the ones who have an influence on the young people who live there and with whom they mix. Members of the neighborhood will exercise social control by helping the young people internalize social norms. Thus, the socio-economic status, cultural capital, and aspirations of the neighbors have an impact on the young people's futures. If an adolescent spends time in a neighborhood where all are involved in bad acts, she or he will be likely to be involved in such act too in the future. As it is said that the area where a person is found most of the time does same things as per norms of that region. Let me give you an example. If you see in your neighborhood that your neighbors are cleaning the neighborhood, they do what is called cleanliness drive at least once a week on a Saturday or a Sunday. They cultivate in you what is called a sense of social drive, because you are seeing your neighbors cleaning the neighborhood. You are seeing your neighbors going on the cleanliness drive. This would inculcate this social drive to clean up your neighbors. So what you do, how you behave also depends on how your neighbors are, whether they are neighbors who have a good sense of social drive, or whether they are neighbors who practice acts like smoking, drinking, or they quarrel a lot, they fight a lot. So if a neighborhood is criminal and violent type, it mostly affects males of the society and lead them towards delinquency. Poor economic condition of a family or neighborhood, both are the source of stress for the child, and in turn child moves towards part of delinquency. When you see a neighborhood wherein there is a lot of deviant behavior, when you see a lot of members of the neighborhood practicing bad acts like gambling or drinking or abusing each other, they would have a lot of influence on young minds, and these young minds in the neighborhoods, these young children in the neighborhood may in most cases also reflect these behaviors in future. So it is very important to have a neighborhood which inculcate good values. A good neighborhood, on the other hand, often would lead to development of children with good values. So when we talk about neighborhood, it is very important to have neighbors, to have neighborhood which is inculcating values within the children, and also you have certain neighborhoods like a neighborhood association like the Resident Welfare Association, which helps in the upkeep of the neighborhood. They would organize meetings, they would organize cleanliness drive, they would organize campaigns like, you know, they would organize camps wherein they would bring in children, or they would they would bring in people from the medical field and would organize seminars and so on and so forth to talk about what are the diseases affecting people, how to be free from all diseases, what are the precautions they have to take. So a good neighborhood is a neighborhood which inculcate values in the children, inculcate good values in the other members of the neighborhood. It is a good neighborhood is a neighborhood which leads to or which brings about a good upkeep of the neighborhood. And what your neighborhood is reflects a lot on what you are as a person, because a bad neighborhood, in most cases, if you are living in a bad neighborhood, it will reflect bad behavior in you. And if you come from a good neighborhood, it reflects good values, and you would reflect what is called a good behavior. So, dear learners, in today's class, we have discussed how home is important, how peer group is important, and how neighborhood is important in value development. Thank you so much for listening.